$22. What are your thoughts?
Talk about inflation. Anyway, we've only got $219 saved. Interest. We've got interest for the first quarter coming. Still isn't very much for 3 months and 5,000 miles. Well, how many guys do you know that have knocked around the way we have and still made it pay? Oh, we sure make it pay. Almost lynched in Guard, drowned in Grand Isle, beat up in New Orleans, blown away by a dust storm in Kanab and arrested in Spare Falls. Our trouble is we have no status.
Who wants status? You've got status, you've got strings. You got strings, you're a puppet. Who wants to be a puppet? Besides, it's the times that's bugging you, Todd. That's what it is, just the times.
Nah, that's no excuse, Buzz. It's always the times. We just don't belong anywhere.
Okay, we'll join a country club. Look, what do you expect, Todd? I mean, everywhere we go, we're just passing through. We're strangers.
You know, somewhere I read, only ants and savages put strangers to death.
All right, we'll find a place with no ants and no savages.
You're the navigator.
Carter Lake, Table Rock, Grants Pass. Now that sounds like a town where it'd be hard to get into trouble.
Good, just some place to relax and maybe do a little fishing, get our laundry done, and let some of the bruises heal.
Says here that he got that prime corn-fed Oregon beef and the best beer this side of Denmark.
The prodigal son home, Sal, as usual. But there's no point in killing a fatted calf. At that rate, even Father would have run out of calves.
I'll take him now.
That's all right, sir. We've got him.
Dinner ready?
Who did it?
Ted.
Ted Becker?
You know it. Kurt was making a spectacle of himself. Ted told him to stop. Kurt hit Ted. Well, you know, nobody hits Ted. Except that one. Boy, you should have seen it. Wham! Outsville. And that great Ted Becker was spread out like peanut butter. What did you say we have for dinner?
Bring him in here.
Maybe you can tell me what happened.
Well, this fellow Becker was cleaning the floor up with your son, and your daughter was crying, so I just...
Crying? Karen was crying?
Yes, sir. She was pretty concerned about her brother until we got here.
Karen!
Did I hear my champion calling? My defender of lost causes? Next time, mind your own business.
Look, I was only trying...
You're always looking for an enemy, brother dear. But you keep on looking in the wrong place. Look over there, in the mirror.
Want to talk about it?
Oh, sure. Why don't we hire a hall so I can tell the whole world all about the Emersons?
Grateful for what you've done. We're about to have dinner. I'd appreciate it if you'd stay.
No, thanks. Thanks
just,
anyway. Passing through.
Well, let me fix you a drink.
I guess it was just sort of luck that we came off. We didn't make any plans. Never do.
You have families waiting, or jobs, or school?
No, sir, nothing.
I see. Well, perhaps I could persuade you to stop here a while. There's a guest house by the pool. My housekeeper's an excellent cook, and I have work for you. We're harvesting the hops just now, and I need every hand I can hire.
Mr. Emerson, do all the hands live in a guest house by the pool and eat your housekeeper's cooking?
No, just you two.
I don't think so. I'm sorry, sir. I guess Buzz and I weren't cut out to be nursemaids.
Well, they need someone their own age. Someone to set them an example. Obviously, I can't.
One thing, defying gravity's another. Some of our trucks are older than you are.
You just keep her around 20 through these fields. No more than 45 on the highway.
Seems to help any more liquor. They use it in medicines, too. Tonics, soporifics. Lecture this morning, please. I don't think I could stand your nagging voice this morning. Mr. Galloway, sir, faithful foreman and obedient servant of my esteemed father.
Maybe your father won't dress you down, but I intend to.
Oh, I'm sure you do. Well, how late am I this morning?
3 hours and 12 minutes, and us already a week late with the harvest. Your dad's got $250,000 in hops out there ready to be processed, plus the other contracts with the growers. 10 more days, that's all we got before the crop rots on the vine. And I mean that's 24 hours a day with everybody being here on time. As long as your father says you're supposed to be my assistant, you're gonna be my assistant. Else I'll throw you right off this property.
Well, that's not a bad idea.
You've been drinking again?
Again? Don't you mean still?
You're in no condition to be around machinery.
In that event, I'll leave.
You're in no condition to drive either.
Let's just say I'm in no condition.
Period.
place in town where a man can drink alone?
I guess I lost my head last night. But you know how I get. You shouldn't have set me off.
No man ever hit me before.
Maybe that's your trouble.
I got no troubles.
There are a few of them as a starter. And you got others. Like too much money. Like a sister you're not man enough to keep at home.
If I knew how to fight, Becker, if anybody had ever taught me how, I'd split that stupid face of yours wide open.
You can't blame me for looking, especially at something choice like your sister, especially when she's looking right back.
I ever catch you looking at her that way again, I'll go get a gun and shoot you dead.
You just don't want a man in the family.
Oh, you. What are you anyway? A pea-brained riverman with a phony racket.
Gentle down now.
Oh, you and that two-bit tourist trip down the rapids. All that junk about how dangerous it is. Any two-year-old could go down the Rogue on an ironing board.
Maybe you'd like to try it.
Why not? I can ride the rapids as well as you. Anybody could.
Easy said.
$500.
For what?
I'll bet you $500. I can get to Hell's Gate before you can, right through the rapids.
You'd never make it. You'd drown before you hit white water. You don't make no difference to me, Sonny. I'm thinking of myself. Your father still owns half this valley. I don't want him on my neck blaming me.
My dad? When did he ever climb on anybody's neck? Why, he'd probably send you a medal. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
why'd you pull me out? Worried about your money?
Not hardly. I was just thinking how your sister tried to help you out in the bar last night when you got in trouble. You know? She's gonna be mighty grateful to me now.
We better be getting back to the plant pretty soon.
Oh, no, you've had a long day today. I think that's enough.
So Mr. Galloway says it's going to be a 24-hour day if we're ever going to get the harvest harvested.
It's that Mr. Becker. He's come to see Karen.
Ask him to come in.
Evening, Mr. Emerson.
You've met my guests, I understand.
Yeah.
I'm very grateful to you for pulling Kurt out today. I think this will cover the wager and the damage to your boats.
I didn't come here to ask you for any money. Mr. Emerson, you can't buy everything with a check.
It's quite true, Mr. Becker. Quite true.
What's the matter? I'm not good enough for the Emersons? You got such a great family here. What's the matter with me?
I don't know much about you, Mr. Becker. Just what I've heard.
Take the check, Becker, and clear out.
I'm a better man than your son and plenty good enough for your daughter.
Don't you see what he's after? Don't you see what he wants?
Good night, Mr. Becker.
Yeah.
Hail the conquering hero. Did you collect your reward?
Not yet.
Not that Kurt's worth much, poor thing. But he's all we got. Would you like me to reward you? Men get such a stupid look on their faces.
Becker! He kissed the lady goodnight. Bye.
Do you want me to go?
Ask a silly question. You!
I didn't say goodnight to you.
It's funny. I didn't miss it.
We got unfinished business.
You're lucky. Keep it that way. Night.
we're so far behind, why don't we just buy more trucks and hire more people?
If you came around more often and took an interest in business, you'd know the answer to that.
Chuck.
Well, I'm sorry, Jerry, but if he was my son, I'd teach him more than just this business.
He's here now, isn't he?
Well, I'm not exactly doing handsprings because of it. He spent more time this morning arguing than helping.
Give him a chance, Chuck.
Think your highness can push a truck?
Trouble with you, Mr. Galloway, you play it too safe, routing the trucks over the main highway. No wonder it's a half-hour haul. I'll show you how to bring a load back in 10 minutes. Yes, the river road. Why have you always been against it? Because it's shorter?
Forget it, Kurt. We don't route that way. You stick to the main highway.
What's the matter? You scared?
Who heard you, Dad?
Did I?
Ready to go now, Jerry.
You can ride along with him if that's what you want. Makes you wonder sometimes. He had a fear of this road, almost an obsession. Can't say I blame him after what happened before. Now, after all these years, it's finally claimed him, too. Yes, sir. Sure makes you wonder. Anytime, Jerry.
You think I tried to kill him? Look, I wasn't going that fast. I came to this stretch of road here, and he, I don't know, he just flipped. He started to shout, and he grabbed at the wheel. Honest, Dad, he grabbed the wheel. I tried to swing back, but we went over. I don't know what got into him.
Chuck Galloway's wife and daughter were killed right here in an accident 25 years ago. Chuck was driving too fast. They pulled him back up alive, just like they pulled you back up now.
You say that like you're sorry they did.
God forgive me for thinking it. Buzz, why are you two operating the ovens? Where are Eddie and Jim? And where are the feeders?
They've all gone.
Gone?
They liked Mr. Galloway. They talked it over and decided they didn't want to work someplace where a man could get himself killed by the boss's son. Not for a dollar and a quarter an hour. Don't forget they added that. So, we're seeing if two men can run a hops factory. They can't. Well, we thought it over and decided to ignore our discovery and just keep working the flash, you know?
I don't know what to say.
Mr. Emerson?
Can't you hire more help?
Not likely. Not this late in the season. Means we'll lose half this year's crop. I'll take my losses, as always next year. But for the outlying growers, and like Harry Parks and Steve Campbell, fellows with only 20 to 50 acres,
It's their whole year's income.
Well, why can't they pitch in and help?
They have been, Buzz. They've been working alongside us, cutting vines. But we need truck drivers, systems feeders, oven room operators, balers. We always pick them up in season from migratory workers.
How about in town? Can't we scout up some emergency help there?
I'll try when I come back from the funeral.
Mr. Emerson, what about Kurt? Shouldn't he be able to help?
You've been storing that question a long time, haven't you, Todd?
Yes. Kurt certainly ought to be able to help.
But how can I blame him when everyone else, even his own sister, blames him for being what I made him? His faults, weaknesses, he didn't learn from a stranger, he learned them from me. Just as I learned mine from my father. My father. To him, the world was clearly divided into two parts, what he already had and what remained to be taken. And what he couldn't take, he destroyed, like some pillaging general. He couldn't take me, so he destroyed me. He made me in his image. For every inch I grew, my hatred for him grew, till I wasn't sure which was me and which was the hatred. Once I dared ask him, Father, I asked, is it that power corrupts a man, or do only corrupt men seek power? He made me repeat the question, and he counted the words off on his fingers. And he whipped me for each word, every day for 15 days in front of my mother. I promised myself if I ever had a son, I'd never be a dictator. I'd let him grow his way, and I'd be man enough in myself to accept it and live with it, good or bad. I never whipped or punished either child. I let them have their own way, take as much rope as they wanted. Looking back now, I can see I wasn't a father at all. I was their host. Well, I raised them wrong. But when I finally saw I'd gone as far one way as my father had gone another, it was too late to get them back. Why is it different with you? And you, what did your fathers do to make you come out all right?
I never knew mine. But the place where they raised me, well, they treated me fair. They showed me all the rules.
Well, Dad and I had problems, but never with each other. They were joint problems, you know. Things we had to face together. What he called the common cause.
The common cause?
Yes, sir. That's why I asked about Kurt, why he wasn't here.
Well, now you know.
Anybody who gets hungry, just go raid the kitchen. Mrs. Hastings had to go to the funeral, so everybody just help yourself.
We'll do it.
Don't worry.
thought you were at the funeral.
Yeah, I'm there with you.
Why should I go? To meet Chuck still alive. I want to keep him that way. Not see some wax figure laid out in a box. In a Sunday suit. With makeup on an empty face.
Little party to help you remember.
What's a suitcase for?
Well, now that's full of Dad's ties. I'm going to the big city and start a tie business on the first corner I come to.
Funny.
Yeah. That's me, coast to coast, king of the comedy hour.
Kurt? You're not kidding?
When are you going to understand, Karen? I've never been kidding. I'm the dedicated kid. I'm the town statue. You think I'm sitting on a horse like General Grant with a bronze sword? Not me, not dedicated Kurt. I'm holding up a silver flask. I'm the town clown. You see, it even rhymes. Well, that's okay. I can live with that. You hand people a few laughs and no harm done. Now there's a new statue of me in the public square, and a different name. Killer. Do you like that, Karen? Killer.
What do you want? Pity?
From you?
You wouldn't know how to accept it.
You wouldn't know how to give it.
All right, go ahead. Walk out. Do you think I'll miss you? I'm not asking for myself. I'm asking for Father. What do you think this will do to him?
He'll survive.
Oh, boy. You're the grateful one.
Me. You talk about me. Well, if it weren't for me pulling you out of one mess after another, showing yourself off all over town, you'd be the worst little...
You're a liar. I never let anybody touch me.
Oh, sure, sure.
And if I had, what do you care?
Don't you see?
See what?
Don't you see I was only trying to help? To give you something?
Give me what, Kurt?
I don't know, maybe... strength. They say you're missing. On all cylinders. Well, it doesn't take a bloodhound to find you. Not if you can follow the smell of the corks, it doesn't.
You're not even gonna say goodbye to your father, huh?
I'll drop him a Dear John letter.
Yeah, that sounds like you.
What are you so worked up about?
Maybe it's because I know what it is to lose a father.
Hey, Mike, make it one for my baby here and two more for me. I think we'll let the road take care of itself this time around. You know, a guy can go broke buying one for the road.
We're leaving.
You'll have to carry me.
That suits me fine.
I can walk. Maybe not a straight line.
Then walk!
Mm-hmm.
think your leaving will solve anything?
Yeah. Yeah, I do.
It might help me to accept it.
You'll tell me how. It'll bring the workers back, for one thing.
How do you figure that?
Well, it was on my account that they left. When they hear I'm gone, they'll come back.
They're gone, Kurtz. They won't be back until next crop. Whether you stay or go, that part's done.
Then there's the town. The way people have been looking at me since the accident.
They'll forget.
I won't. Well, I guess there's nothing else I can say.
You can say you're sorry for being such a fool, and you can take off your coat and go to work with the rest of us.
I'll write you when I get where I'm going. Do you have any money?
Some. You're gonna help him.
He's my son.
And make him stay.
How?
Mr. Emerson, for the first time in your life, whether it does any good or not, for your own sake, you could knock some sense into him. This is your last chance.
Kurt! You're not leaving.
Oh, Dad. Cut it out.
Too late, as always.
Business. What am I bid for 4 weeks' work? 10 hours a day on the levee. Lift that bale, tote that barge. At Dad's factory.
Oh, no.
Grimsville? Just 2 more weeks of vacation and then hung up with the books till next June? Karen, baby, get with it. Come on.
Oh, honey, why fight it? Anyway, we just decided to go on a little picnic this afternoon. You and I, you were down for the Franks and the mustard, you.
I can't go. I have to help my father. Or find someone who will. Somebody like Ted Becker, maybe. Have fun.
So who's gonna bring the Franks and mustard?
Ted?
Karen, about last night.
It was my fault.
Oh, I'm not sorry I kissed you. Just sorry they broke us up.
What if I were to ask you a favor? A big favor.
Well, just ask.
Well, you heard about the workman leaving my father?
I heard.
Well, you have friends. Well, I see you drinking with them. That little man with a bald head?
Tony.
And the other one with a scar on his face?
Frankie.
Oh, and any others. It's only for a week, Ted. If you can only bring them to the factory.
Maybe I can help you, Karen. It depends.
Taking the trip, Kurt? Does it show? See your bags in the back. Want to check your oil, your battery? No, they're okay. Your radiator? Plenty of water. Any particular place? What? You going any particular place? Well, if it is particular, Mr. Evans, you can be sure it won't want me, will it? You the fella stay at his place, huh?
Yeah.
Well, maybe he can tell me what to do then. At least till Mr. Emerson gets back. Well, Karen said he needed all the help he could get. Well, I don't care that much about picnics, you know. Anyway, I came on in then. Oh, my brother, he'll be over tonight as soon as he's had supper. He'd be here now, except he works over in the Franklin Hardware store till 5.
Welcome aboard, friend.
Yeah, I'll tell you what you can do. Maybe I better show you. You know, you've restored my faith in your generation. Well, what got me was Karen saying she's going to Ted Becker?
Yeah.
For help. What do you think she just said that, huh?
Give me the keys to the car.
Where are you going?
Well, there's this man that's big in the unfinished business department.
Becker's no pushover.
He's gonna push him.
Ain't nobody here but us spiders. Come on in.
No, thank you.
Oh, come on. Now, you're not going to let me drink alone, are you, honey? I mean, nobody likes to do things alone. You take your dad. He doesn't like to work alone, does he? Well, I got no use for these guys who try to get a girl drunk. I mean, who needs that?
Thank you.
you're so glad you couldn't wait until I left town. Don't worry. I'm leaving. I just wanted to see it with my own eyes, that's all. Okay, I've seen it. My sister running down here to throw herself at a dirty old bag of muscle.
You're welcome, Chad.
You two look a mess. Come on, Kurt, let's go home.
How can I, Karen?
Because we need you.
They say in town there's work out here for those who need it. I need it, Dad.
yourself.
Please don't tell me I ought to see the other guy. I can't even stand looking at you.
I just remembered something. Is it good for bruises? Knowing Mr. Emerson and Karen and Kurt brought it to mind, something Dad used to say.
What's that?
Whenever you reach an impasse, look at the third side of the coin.
Third side?
Yeah.
I thought there was only two sides to a coin.
The third side is the edge, the place the two sides come together, the meeting place of heads and tails. Dad used to say that was the best side because it welds opposites together. And it's a circle, a continuing circle, closed and perfect, as endless as understanding itself.
This has been a-